When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the one who does not ask Allah, the one who doesn't supplicate to Allah, Allah is angry with him. Allahu Akbar. Hadith is sahih. And a person must also know the reasons for why the dua is rejected and keep away from those matters. So these conditions and manners of an accepted dua are many. Because if we're able to bring these conditions and manners alive in our dua, then that is the type of dua that would never be rejected and would be actually answered. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah has an excellent summary in a few lines in where he mentioned the most important things that a person needs to know when making dua. First matter, and he began, he said that your heart is present when making dua. So it's not just the tongue that is moving when you're making dua, but you must also involve your heart when you're making dua. And this is from the very first condition of an accepted dua. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said concerning this point, you all better know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept a dua that comes from a heedless, distracted heart. So this means, in order for you to achieve a present heart in dua, you must keep away from two things, heedlessness and distraction. What is heedlessness in dua? Heedlessness is when you do not acknowledge the greatness of Allah and the greatness of Allah's mercy. So if you make dua and you say, oh Allah, forgive me. Oh Allah, bestow your mercy upon me. But in your heart, you doubt. I doubt Allah will forgive me. I doubt Allah will grant me His mercy. If that's your heart while making dua, then your heart is not present. You must be certain. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when you ask Allah, ask Him while you are certain that He will answer you. You must also keep away from distraction. What does it mean that the heart is distracted? Two things. Number one, that when you make dua, you must make dua that you understand. If you make dua, you're not understanding, that means your heart is distracted. You are not understanding what you're asking. Therefore, make dua that you understand. If you don't know how to make dua in Arabic, make it in English or in your language. This is permissible, this is fine, this is allowed. Even in salat, al-ulama rahimahumullah, they said, if you do not know how to make dua in Arabic, then you're allowed to make dua in your language until you understand how to make dua in Arabic, or until you learn it.